Okay, hi Virgos, welcome back to my channel, guys. If you are new here, welcome, and if you are returning, thanks so much for supporting the channel. So we're going to go ahead and do a general message, and let's see who's obsessing over my Virgos, okay, at this time. Now, this is a general message, so it may not resonate with everyone. Just take what resonates for you and leave the rest. Anybody interested in a personal reading, my information is always down below. Thanks to those who do reach out for those, and thanks to those who donate to the channel, and to those of you who do subscribe. It's very much appreciated. So I do hope that everybody is well, okay, Virgos? But Spirit, who is obsessing over my Virgos at this time? Just give me the strongest energy here. Give me three cards. My Virgos, Sun, Moon, Rising, North Node, and Venus. Who is obsessing over Virgo? Can I get three cards? Thank you, Spirit. And two more cards. My Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, North Node, and Venus. Heavy air sign coming up. These cards are very flimsy. Thank you. So we have heavy air, Aquarius and Libra. And then we have fire, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. For some of my Virgos, I feel like the energy here with this Aquarius and Libra energy, I feel like whoever this is that is obsessing over you, it could be because maybe you have healed from something, right? Because it's kind of giving me like the star energy, right? And things could definitely be balanced out for you, or they are being balanced out for you with the Libra energy. This also makes me feel like things turning in your favor with that justice energy. Show me more, Spirit. Who is obsessing over my Virgos? So we have the Five of Cups. So it looks like someone who is crying over spilt milk here. This could have been somebody that maybe you was in a relationship with. Seven of Swords. This could have been someone that was a liar, a cheater, a thief here, right? I'm also feeling with that Seven of Swords energy, I'm hearing the word strategy. So this could have been someone that was maybe trying to strategically do something here, right? Six of Cups, definitely could be somebody from your past. For some of you, this could even be like a karmic soulmate. You have the Devil card coming out here, Capricorn energy. So there's the obsession. It feels like if you look in this card, right, you see that this woman is like, almost like she's on her knees and that, and it's almost like her arms are binded behind her. So this could have been someone that wanted to keep you bound to them or stuck to them. This could have been someone that you had a very toxic relationship with. It's almost like this energy, whoever this is, they wanted some sort of power or some sort of control over you. If you look at this Devil, how he's kind of like standing over her, and he's got like a axe in one hand and something that looks like some sort of a wand in the next hand, and it just kind of feels a little bit threatening and intimidating here. And this woman is, she's butt naked. So for some of you, this could even have been maybe somebody that tried to control you with like sex and intimacy, like tried to hold that kind of power over you. What's the Five of Cups and the Devil? Yeah, the Eight of Cups. All right, what's the Eight of Cups? And the Page of Wands. I feel like for some of my Virgos, right, this is maybe, like I said, somebody that you released yourself from here with this Eight of Cups energy. This talks about walking away from something, abandoning it. So this could be someone who maybe you bruised their ego or pride or something like that, right? This could be someone who has like abandonment wounds, right? Or they don't like rejection here. And like I said, you know, the Eight of Cups is on its way to the Nine of Cups. So some of you did the right thing by walking away. But not only did you do the right thing by walking away, it's like you opened up some new doors here for yourself. What's this Seven of Swords? What's this Seven of Swords? Yeah, High Priestess in the reverse, and then you have this Five of Pentacles in the reverse. For some of you, this may have been someone that maybe they kept you as some sort of mistress or secret here, or maybe with the Seven of Swords and the High Priestess in the reverse, it's talking about some sort of secrets coming out about this person. Now, for others of you, it makes me feel like this is someone who didn't want you to kind of like listen to your intuition, right? They didn't want you to listen to your inner voice. High Priestess. High Priestess in the reverse also talks about an energy of manipulation, cunning, trickery. So I see why it's paired with the Seven of Swords here. This also talks about wasted talent and illusions and deception. So what's the Five of Pentacles in the reverse? Let's see if we can find it. Never the card I want. Yeah, so the like Five of Pentacles in the reverse, it talks about someone who is coming out of hardship, right? They're coming out of some sort of financial struggle. It also talks about positive change. So that's what I was saying with the Libra energy. I feel like for some of my Virgos, it's almost like the scales have been balanced. So that is how you know that you did the right thing by walking away from this person here, right? Because you will see that your life is starting to improve. You will start to see that you start to feel better, right? More uplifted, where with this devil energy, you were probably feeling kind of low vibrational, like you kind of like motivational, right? You just kind of like, it kind of feels just kind of low, you know, like that energy when you're kind of like feeling sad about something, so you don't want to do anything, you don't really eat, you don't do this, you're not your normal self. But I feel like with that Five of Pentacles in the reverse, no, I feel like for some of you, you would have felt some sort of improvement here. Yeah, thank you, Spirit. They're saying just more balanced. See, sometimes Spirit says to me, you know what, Rising Phoenix, sometimes, you know, you saying less is more kind of an energy. But I be trying to, like, explain for you, look, so you understand. And they just be like, huh? So, yeah, I guess just feeling more balanced, like this scales, right? So what is the Six of Cups? What is the Six of Cups energy? Coming out almost sideways, landed on that High Priestess in the reverse. This could be someone who is maybe obsessed with you, right? Like I said, I don't know if you know something about this person's past. I don't know, because the Nine of Swords talks about anxiety, stress, and worry here. Sleepless nights. Now, this person could definitely behave this way because of sort of some childhood wounds. Something they maybe they haven't got over here. What's the Nine of Swords with the Six of Cups? Yeah, the Six of Wands, and that's interesting. I wish I would have said it. I'm looking at the card, but I could only see the top where I'm looking at these two gold fishes, and I kept hearing abundance. But then I was also thinking to myself, okay, abundance doesn't always necessarily talk about financial wealth, right? Some of you could be getting blessed financially, but it was more giving me with the two gold fishes. For some of you, this is someone who's maybe worried about you going into a relationship or partnership with somebody else and it being successful. And I'm also hearing, when I'm looking at this card here, Virgos, okay, this, some of my Virgos, I'm hearing, I got my mind on my money and my money on my mind. So that is where your focus is for some of you. And then this, look at this, Nine of Swords with the Six of Wands. This is someone who is stressing out, right? They could be spying on you here with this Page of Swords. But this is someone who is worried about you having some sort of success and victory, public recognition. Or they're just worried about you being in this energy of feeling confident and almost enthusiastic about the future, right? She's holding on to that Ace of Wands and she looks happy. She looks ready to face this new journey. She looks ready to go on, to just start a new chapter. Some of you guys could be looking real good. You may be looking real sexy here with this woman here, right? Maybe you're just very attractive at this time. But it's that energy of how you feel inside. It's almost like it's oozing out. Show me more. Who is this person that is obsessed with my Virgos? Five of Cups, the Devil, and the Eight of Cups. Too many cards. Thank you, Spirit. Okay, so all these fell on the floor, but we will have a look at them. Look at this, Nine of Pentacles with the Judgment and the Knight of Pentacles. So that makes the Ten of Pentacles energy, Virgos, okay? So regardless, again, like I'm saying, whether this is about a relationship, some of my Virgos, it may have taken you a while, okay? But you are on your way here to the Ten of Pentacles energy. For some of you, this person could have tried to delay something for you. But judgment. Final decision. And for some of you, this is someone who's seeing that you made the final decision about them. You got a King of Cups here with the Ace of Pentacles. Some of you, you may be meeting somebody new. Maybe you manifested this for yourself, right? Magician and the Nine of Cups. You're following your heart's desire. And I feel like that is what the Most High wants. So it's almost like some of you really need to like applaud yourself, commend yourself. That was too many cards. Five of Cups, the Devil, and the Eight of Cups. You have the Two of Swords and the Star card. Yeah, you're closed off to this person, right? This person is at a crossroads here. Some of you, you had a decision to make and you chose correctly. You chose yourself. You chose to heal. You chose to hold on to faith, hope. This is feeling rejuvenated, feeling good, right? And I always sometimes see this Star card here as well, where this woman is pouring out a jug. And I feel like for some of you, you just don't have those emotions for this person anymore. What is this Seven of Swords, the High Priestess in the reverse, and the Five of Pentacles in the reverse? I just need one card. Yeah, some of you are getting back out there. You're celebrating. Maybe meeting up with friends, just living life again. Maybe you've been stuck for a while, right? But one card. Thank you. Yeah, the Six of Swords, moving to calmer waters. This is no longer dealing with, you know, the petty games and the kind of tick for tack, right? No more. It's just that energy of no more, Virgos. You see, this woman is sailing into the sun. And again, this energy where that Nine of Pentacles came out, for some of Virgos, you're doing it alone. What is this Six of Cups, Nine of Swords, and Six of Wands? Queen of Pentacles with the Hermit and the Queen of Wands. Okay, so not only are you standing in your power here, right? Hold on. Yeah, not only are you standing in your power here, Virgos, because some of you, like I said, you did some sort of introspection, self-reflection here with the Hermit energy. In this deck, you see that the Hermit is talking to a bird, listening to your intuition, following the divided, following the guidance of your ancestors and your angels here. And Queen of Wands, I feel like you're confident. Nine of Wands, you ready to take on a challenge here, right? This is an energy of you not giving up. This talks about perseverance here. Who is this Queen of Wands? Because I feel like with the two queens coming out here, it kind of makes me feel like you sitting in Empress or Emperor energy, like Divine Masculine, Divine Feminine, the Sun card, Leo energy. And then you have the Chariot in the reverse. So for some of you, this person could even be a feminine energy that may be hating on you, right? Could be a Leo energy. Because the Chariot in the reverse, this talks about somebody not having a victory, not having a success. And maybe this is someone who is questioning themselves with the Hermit energy about what it is that they're doing wrong here, right? What's the Chariot in the reverse? Eight of Pentacles and this World card and the Five of Swords. Yeah, if someone here was trying to affect your business or something like that here, or just affect you, right? What did I say about the Six of Swords? It's moving away from the Five of Swords. Some of you moving away from that Five of Swords and you're focused on your work, your projects, your creativity, right? Your jobs, if you have your own businesses and things like that. And it feels like with the World card, you may be having some sort of success. Right. You could do something on the internet where people can see it. Right. You may have a platform or something like that. Someone wanted you to, I'm hearing fail. Yeah. They wanted you to fail. But it looks like Spirit and the Most High, that he had other plans for you. So show me more about this person. Let me put these away. Spirit, show me more about this person who is obsessed with Virgo. Yeah, happiness hater. I'm telling you, some of you are in a new relationship or you're gonna be here. Tell me more about this person who is obsessed with my Virgos. Give me a clear message. Thank you, Spirit. Thank you. You have always partying. You have a drama starter. Clarify these cards. Yeah, we have ego. It says her ego. It says ego getting in the way of relationship, etc. You have wasting time. It says stuck, no changes. It says limited. So that's what that Chariot in the reverse was about. What's always partying? You have same shit, different day. Oh, we have child services. So this could be someone who has some sort of legal situations going on with child services and it hitting the justice card, right? It says kids at risk of being taken or is about to. It says reporting something. It says neglect and abuse. So this could be someone who is more interested in going out, getting drunk, right? Or indulging in whatever it is that they indulge in here, right? Same energy every day. And this could be even someone who has children and they don't even put that much time or effort into looking after those children. So I don't know, maybe someone called social services on this person. I'm also hearing something about maybe something being reported, like maybe the school or something reporting something here. I don't know. I'm also hearing something about maybe even neighbors calling social services on this person because maybe something about a baby always crying. Or there's always arguing in a household. What is this drama starter? You have creeping. So definitely spying on you. Definitely invested in you, Virgos. Show me more. Yeah, and we have kissing ass. What is kissing ass? Because this could be someone that kind of wants to come back around, right? What is kissing ass? We have no facts. It says never has the facts, makes shit up and lies. Now, for some of you, this is someone who maybe, right, they tried to, like, gossip or spread some sort of lies about you or tried to make you look like a certain type of way, right? But it kind of feels like with all that positive energy that was coming out for you, Virgos, it's almost like impossible for them to kind of attach that stigma to you because it kind of feels like it's that energy where the proof is in the pudding, right? And it's almost like this person, people may be starting to look at this person as a liar or, like I said, a hater or someone who's just completely obsessed with your energy, obsessed with you. Tell me more about this person. We have depth. It says awareness, importance, and value. What is depth? We have, lusting. It says forbidden, non-committal, and sexual energy. Show me more. And you have clinging. It says holding on, obsessing, and spying. So I don't know if this person is lusting after you. This is, okay, this feels like that energy. You know where there's like a thin line between love and hate, unless it's just different energies for different Virgos, right? But yeah, this could be someone who is codependent. Maybe with the depth, you know that this is someone who has some real issues. Show me more. You have thinking. It says missing you, craving and desiring. You have pride. It says arrogance, ego and stubborn. And then coming out sideways, which is a blockage, is commitment. So for some of you, is this someone that you're married to? Maybe you lived with this person for some of you, right? Again, for some of you, you could still be married to this person, but again, maybe you're just putting a blockage here. For some of you, this is someone who wanted to be married or in a relationship with you, but I just feel like you're not interested. Marriage, promises, and fidelity. Now, it landed on lusting. So this could have been someone you walked away from because you meant to be in a commitment or relationship with them and they are entertaining other people or they just can't control, like I said, their urges maybe. This could be someone with the depth and you see this person swimming down into the sea. Someone who has some real kind of like buried problems. Tell me more. You have stress. It says turbulence, tension and arguments. And you have broken. It says shattered, heartbroken and destroyed. And then you have finality. It says farewells, leave behind, and closure. Yeah, for some of my Virgos, since you walked away, it's almost like these people that they are, it feels like suffering with like anxiety. They got a lot of issues, a lot of maybe debt and things like that. For some of you, this person can't even focus at work or something. Anything else, Spirit? Yeah, you have memories. It says reminiscing, dwelling, and bittersweet. You have silence. It says frozen, no words, stone wall. And then you have boundaries. Yeah. No, it says drawing the line, and it says enough. Someone you put boundaries up with. And kudos to you. All right, Spirit, what's the advice for Virgos? I don't really see that you have anything to worry about here. But I just like to kind of like check in every now and again. So you have learn from life, you have meditation for peace, and then you have plant the seeds. Yeah, so you keep kind of growing whatever it is that you're growing here, Virgos, right? Spirit is clearly saying to me that you learned more than enough from this situation or from this person. And now you just want kind of peace in your life, right? Remember that devil at the beginning? What's the advice for Virgos? Some of you definitely could be studying right now. You have rebirth and rejuvenation. Yeah. Some of you have had a transformation. You've outgrown this person, this situation. I don't know if I've seen something about somebody getting baptized. So you have meditation for clarity. One more. Or two more. Thank you. You have water magic. So again, these things like spiritual baths, right? Keeping your spiritual cleanliness up. And what is this one? You have speak your mind. And I always say with this card, it makes me feel like you having some sort of conversation with your ancestors and angels here. So, you know, speaking up what it is that you want. You see that she has like the wish flower in her hand. It's almost like your wishes are being granted here, Virgos. Like I was saying, things being balanced out for you. Where I was saying your ancestors and angels, the Most High saying, hey, listen, applaud yourself. Yeah, you're standing your ground. Some of you have stepped into your power. So I love to see it. So Virgos, that is what I have for you, okay? That's the energy that I've picked up here today. I do hope that something has resonated with you. If it has, I do ask that you hit the thumbs up for me, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell so you know when I upload. But if this is where we part, Virgos, stay safe. Love and light, guys.